Now we'll find number of strictly increasing and strictly decreasing functions defined from set A to set B. So we have this function f defined from set A to set B. Suppose set A has n elements and say the elements are a1, a2, a3 and an, and set B, it has m elements, which are b1, b2 and bm. Number of elements in set A, it is n, and number of elements in set B is m. Now we need to find number of strictly increasing functions defined from A to B. Now in order to define strictly increasing functions, the elements in set A, they must be arranged in some order. So what we'll do is we'll assume that the elements in A are such that A1 is less than A2, is less than A3, and it is less than An. So for simplicity, we have assumed that this set A is an ordered set in which A1 is the smallest element and An is the largest element. And by doing so, we have not changed the question. We have rearranged the elements in the set. So the question will either be find number of strictly increasing functions from A to B, or they may ask you to find number of functions from A to B such that fai is less than faj whenever I is less than j. Now we know that any strictly increasing function is a 1-1 function. So this function from A to B, it has to be a 1-1 function, and it can only be a 1-1 function when the value of m, it is greater than or equal to n. Now if m is less than n, in that case there'll be no 1-1 function possible. So their number of strictly increasing or decreasing function will simply be 0. Now we'll consider this general case when m is greater than or equal to n. Now since it is a 1-1 function, from these m elements we have to select n elements so that we can get image for each element. Now n elements from m can be selected in mc n ways. So now we have n elements in A and we have n elements in B. Now we have to map each element in A with an element in B so that fai is less than faj. That means selected n numbers in set B must be mapped with elements in A in an ascending order. Now in how many ways we can arrange n distinct elements in ascending order? There is only one way possible. So number of strictly increasing function, or for that matter number of strictly decreasing function also, from set A to set B is given by mcn whenever m is greater than or equal to n. And if m is less than n, number of such functions will be simply 0. The problem becomes little more interesting when it says number of non-increasing or non-decreasing functions defined from set A to set B. So suppose again we have set A in which elements are ordered, say A1 is less than A2 is less than A3 is less than An, and suppose now elements in set B are also ordered, say B1, B2, B3 and Bm. Now this again is rearrangement of elements in set, so nothing has changed in the question. Now we need to define functions from A to B such that fai is less than equal to faj whenever I is less than j. Now there is an equality sign here, so it is no longer an increasing function here. Now how do we solve this question? Now one way of solving this problem can be, we can say that suppose the number of elements in A which are mapped to B1 is say n1, number of elements in A which are mapped to B2, they are n2, and number of elements which are mapped to Bm is nm. Now each of the element in A, it must be mapped to 1b. So from here we can say n1 plus n2 plus n3 plus nm, and this value, it must be equal to n. Now we need to find number of non-negative integral solution of this equation. Number of non-negative integral solution of this equation will be n plus m minus 1 cn. So number of non-decreasing functions from A to B will be given by n plus m minus 1 cn. Now how does this work? Suppose one case is when all the elements, they are mapped to B1. So that case will correspond to the solution when the value of n1 is 10 and all the remaining variables, they take the value 0. Another case could be when suppose two of them, they are mapped to b1 and then remaining n minus 2, they are mapped to b2. So it could be 2, n minus 2 and then rest all 0. So all the possible non-decreasing mapping from a to b will correspond to solution of this equation, which is n1 plus n2 plus n3 plus nm equals m. And this solution is given by n plus m minus 1 cn. And the same formula works for number of non-increasing functions. Now, another method to work out the same formula is, suppose we consider two sets A and B, which are 1, 2, 3, all the way up to n. And then this set B containing elements 1, 2, 3, up to m. Now, there is a one-to-one correspondence between number of non-decreasing functions in this case to number of non-decreasing functions in any general case. Now here we need to define functions from a to b such that fx is less than equal to fy whenever x is less than y. Now we'll define another set, which is say b1, and this b1 is 1, 2, 3 up to m, and then we'll have m plus 1, m plus 2 and m plus n minus 1. Now what we'll do is we'll define a function say g from a to b1 such that gn is fn plus n minus 1. So in other words, we can write g1 as f1, g2 as f2 plus 1, g3 as f3 plus 2 and gn as fn plus n minus 1. Now this function f, it is non-decreasing if and only if when this function g is strictly increasing. Now basically this transformation of f to g is a bijection from non-decreasing functions from a to b to strictly increasing functions from a to b. Now for this set g, we can find number of strictly increasing functions. Now for g, there are m plus n minus 1 elements, and for these n elements, we need to choose n elements from these, and they have to be ordered in ascending order, which can be done in m plus n minus 1 c n ways. So number of strictly increasing functions g from a to b1 is m plus n minus 1 cn, and which is equal to number of non-decreasing functions f from a to b. So number of non-decreasing functions is again m plus n minus 1 cn. So this is how we find number of non-increasing or non-decreasing function for given two sets a and b.